session, which will be presented by the Toastmaster Ratan Shetty. He'll be here at 4. He's running a little late. Then we'll have the speech evaluation, followed by the general evaluation, and then we'll wrap it up. So without wasting much more time, let me invite Praveen, the Toastmaster, the table topic master.
Very good afternoon to all the Toastmasters and the speech crafters.
Good afternoon.
After long traffic, I came here 4 minutes late. I'm very sorry for it. So I'll start the table topic round with starting with all in the sequence order, and everyone have to come. And our first name is Mrs. Your topic is Facebooking time pass activity.
Yes, I feel that Facebooking is a time pass activity. Why? Because, you know, personally, when I talk for myself, hardly you see me on Facebook. Why? Because I feel that it is only you are sharing your personal thought, personal inputs, personal agendas to others. Is it benefiting you? No, you are doing a propaganda. You are just doing a propaganda, and you are, you know, telling that to the entire world that this is what you are up to, and this is my profile, this is what I am planning to do in the future also. I have seen a lot of people going around the world, right? You're traveling. Immediately they update on Facebook telling that I'm traveling. I'm in London, I'm in Mexico, I'm in this place, that place. Is it required for others? I don't know whether it is required for your friends or relatives. No. Right? So I feel like Facebook is just waste of time. It is just propaganda.
And next is Rahul. And the topic is hard work or smart work, which one is important?
Right. So I have been thinking on this topic quite some time. Not because Praveen told me, but it's a part of a group discussion topics in my upcoming interviews. So getting to the point, hard work or smart work? I believe that smart work will have a better impact than hard work. Because in smart work, you're not just putting in intense effort, but you're putting the effort in a right way and in the right direction. You want to achieve something, you just can't, it's not just blood and sweat, but it also requires lot of thinking to do. Now for example, you have a business. To achieve a good profit, you need to think and work on it. Keep discussing with your clients. As compared to working out in the gym, you just have to lift barbells, lift dumbbells, do push-ups. That's the only hard work over there. So yes, I believe that smart work is more effective than hard work. Thank you.
Innovation for women would help the society. Innovation for women would help the society.
Reservation. Okay. Good afternoon all. So I think what topic he has given, it's a very important topic in today's world. Because I personally feel reservation is not required. But in India, in today's world, in our country, we see that there are so many benefits which normal people like us, we don't get, but they're all kept aside for reservations. Whether it is with regard to education or job, we see so many people, so many good candidates, so many smart people, intelligent people who have been toppers in school, colleges. They don't get job or they don't get seat in medical college or engineering college. Medical colleges and such cars. Like, I don't have anything against, but I feel that everyone should get an equal right, education-wise or job-wise. Because we are all living in this world, and we need to make a life for ourselves. We should not take a path of, you know, a preference or something.
And the next contestant is Shilpa. And your topic is beauty contests degrade women.
Hi guys, so the topic, in case you didn't hear, is that do beauty contests degrade women? Well, my opinion, I'm sure this is very debatable, but my opinion would be that it actually gives women a chance to compete, contest, and it is a pride of a nation, because a beautiful girl representing a country like India and wins, like Aishwarya Rai, brought a lot of fame, brought a lot of attention and recognition that women in India are beautiful also. And I think some of the most beautiful looking wise, I don't know about the character, but they are here. So it does teach, and these women who become, who win contests, go out and do a lot of social work and good work, and they also talk about world peace in these contests. So I think it's a good thing, and it doesn't degrade women. Thank you.
And the next contestant is Mr. Joseph Jones. The topic is Indian villages, our strength, our power meters.
Indian villages is our strength or our weakness, right? Actually, once Gandhiji made this remark, if you want to see the heart of India, we should move to villages. What I believe is, you know, even today, probably it must be a neglected lot, but the real success of India comes from the villages. Because even today, ours is a country which wherein there is the agriculture drives the economy here, and most of them comes from the villages, and it's actually a bone, and we should put more focus on the villages, giving them more facilities, empowering them to do more and contribute more to the country.
He is from IIT Kanpur. So now he is very old. Now if you can see his YouTube, if you have time, if you watch, you can see so many interesting things, how he teaches things very interestingly. So I feel that now the education system should change something like which Anil Gupta is doing. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Praveen, for changing.
Where you are heading to, what is up waiting for you, what can you actually do something better and better. So just about how you can actually capitalize on what you have and striving toward excellence with the kind of friends and circle or any kind of people who are actually helping you out with everything. So just about being positive, remain positive and understand the values of life, and ethical thinking can actually result in good manner and conservative thinking.
Or 50, you are seeing much more of life. But
probably as the tried, he chose to pick up the good from the society, and he chose to, he or she wanted to see, want to go deeper into the life aspects. Whereas maybe a person who is much older, maybe he or she might have not decided or made choices to actually learn from life. Instead, they might have just led a boring, plain life. They haven't actually learned anything. Or it can be the other way around as well. So I really don't think age has got nothing to do with being practical or mature. It's your perception.
Thanks to everyone. Everyone spoke so well done. And now it's time to conclude.
Thank you, Praveen. That was a very nice session on the table topics. Now, shall we move on to the prepared speeches?
Yes, please.
Okay. The first speaker loves listening to songs. She loves traveling, and she designs clothes. Today she's gonna speak. She's gonna pop up an anecdote from her house. She's none other than Evie Chow.
Just a moment, please.
Yeah. So for the people joining us this week, this is the cycle of evaluation. Suppose you are speaking, you will benefit by Rahul this way, right? Apurva and Shilpa, the other way around.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
So how was your weekend? Hope you have done well and enjoyed your Saturdays and Sunday we are here. So I came back after a long holiday, so I'm full into about standing here and talking to you guys. Today I'm talking about a financial management solution wherein I'm personally involved in my personal development. Here I romance with finance. I don't know whether people romance with finance. Why? Because what does romancing? Romancing is not love and affection only for people. It is the life. What is life ahead? Life ahead is always with money. I don't know whether you agree with it, right? You always think about tomorrow, not for today. I don't know how many people think about tomorrow. I've seen hardly few people thinking about tomorrow than thinking about today. I'm a person who always think about 5 years down the line, 10 years down the line. So that is what I'm talking about, romancing in life with financial aspects. Okay? Today, I would like to tell you how I bought a flat by romancing with finance and planning my life. Okay? When my son was in 7th standard, he was just 12 years old. I'm talking about a long way back. I told him, I want to buy a flat when you are in 10th standard. So you can understand, when he was in 2nd standard, I learned my all the way what he should be and what he should have when he was in 10th standard. He said, can you do it? Yes, why not? Let me plan. I started putting little money here and there. I used to put in mutual fund and I used to put in, chins and all. Over a period of time, what I saw was, whatever small investment I used to put, it grew like a tree, right? Small one, multiple branches, I had a lot of money. But towards the end, did I have enough money to buy flat? No. So when he was in 9th standard, one of my friend told me that, there is a friend of hers who is a builder, who is planning to build a house, build an apartment and give it on rent as well as sell it. Why don't you look out? I went, looked at the site, but I was not convinced. Why? Because I used to have certain parameters in selecting certain things. When I went there, it was a barren land, no people around, there was one apartment being constructed. I did not tell yes or no, I said, time will say. few months, again they call me back in the month of October, telling me that for Dasara they are planning for a, you know, Bhumi Puja as well as the foundation. Why don't you look at it? You will get a good price because early bird offer. I said, okay, fine, let me go have a look at it. I went there, but still I was not convinced. Why? Because I felt that, you know, he may cheat me. That is what, whenever you have a financial investment, you always think twice. So what I did was, I was thinking twice. So one of my friends called me and said, even I am investing, if you feel that that guy is cheating or if you feel that things are not going in the right direction, I'll make sure your, you know, funds are replaced, you know, refunded. I said, okay, fine. I went and paid 50,000 rupees and booked the flat. After 1 year, again, he called me back. It was just 26 flats there, wherein, you know, there were 2-bedroom flats and 3-bedroom flats. After a few months, he said, you know, I'm giving a 2-bedroom flat for my people, but I would like to sell all 3-bedroom flats. So I went ahead and blocked 3-bedroom flats. But that point of time, I was in financial crisis. Okay? So when the financial crisis came, did people come to rescue me?
No.
Yes, that is the point I'm going after. When you are in financial crisis, nobody comes to your rescue. Okay? So it's always better you invest whatever money you have and save yourself. Always save what is there with you before spending. Spend what you, you know, have. Don't spend more. And towards the end, my suggestion to you all is, you know, whatever money you have, keep it with you. You lend money also, they will not return in time. Still, I have lakhs of rupees which has to come back to me. I haven't got it. Thank you.
Thank you, Veja, for that money talk. You told us a way to save money. That is so useful. The next speaker loves listening to songs.